Episode 94, Stop Puking, Start Selling. Welcome to Be Who You Want to Be, Your Business, Your Life, the podcast for micropreneurs, designing your business and your life on your own terms. I'm your host, Candice Rodarte, and today I'm joined by the direct sales domme, Jennie Bellinger.
Hey!
Jennie is a certified business, a certified professional coach, and host of the Badass Direct Sales Mastery podcast. It is an awesome podcast, y'all. She works with badass direct sales moms who are ready to double their monthly income. An entrepreneur since 2010, she understands the desire to contribute to your family's future and be present with them in the here and now, and how difficult balancing those two priorities can be. So Jennie has learned the hard way while building two separate businesses, raising two kids, and navigating a divorce to fulfill that need to contribute and be there for her children. Welcome, Jennie.
Thanks for having me on the show, Candice. Oh, I'm so excited to be here with you today.
We've already spent 20 minutes talking about everything but business, so let's talk business. So tell us Let's tell us your story. How'd you get to where you are?
Well, it all started once upon a time. This guy got a twinkle in his eye. No, I'm just kidding. my business story starts in the classroom. I started as a middle school science teacher and took some time off to be a mom and got pregnant with my oldest child and decided I was not ready to spend 40 to 60 hours away from my child every single week, not including drive time. So including drive time, it would have been more than that because as a teacher, we all know how much teachers work. And so I really took some time off to be mom. And then when I was like, okay, well, maybe it's time for me to go back into the world of teaching. It also happened to be the middle of a recession. So schools didn't have money for an award-winning teacher who had experience if they also had the option to potentially hire a brand new college grad. So, and I don't fault the schools for that. And it was the universe's way of telling me, this is not where you're meant to be any longer. You've served your purpose in education. Now it's time to go move on and educate in a different way. I just didn't know what that was. So once I hit my full level of frustration, I went, okay, universe, fine. If not education, where am I supposed to be? And 2 days later, I opened my mailbox and like my literal mailbox, you know, out by my driveway. And there's an invitation to a direct sales party, actually a fashion show being held by a direct sales company local to my area. I'm in the St. Louis area. And so I went, okay, that's an interesting thing, universe. I'll see your bluff. And I went to that fashion show. Because at the time I was a stay-at-home mom with, you know, wearing t-shirts and jeans. And, you know, I was not a fashionista. So I thought it was really funny that I specifically got invited to a fashion show and showed up to said fashion show in jeans, t-shirt, and sneakers. No makeup, no jewelry. Like that's how I showed up to a fashion show, y'all. So while I was there, got introduced to this direct sales company that was looking to build in my area. And I walked away with a business. So I got started with my direct sales company. Am I allowed to say the name of the company?
Oh,
I mean, I'm not with them
absolutely.
Anymore.
Absolutely.
Okay. Okay, so I signed on with Park Lane Jewelry in the fall of 2010 and said, okay, I'm going to do this for at least a year. I'm not allowed to give up for a whole year. I've got to give it my all for 12 months before I can give up. Because I knew as somebody who was, I'm literally diagnosed ADD, have been since I was 23 years old. I knew the new shiny would eventually wear off, right? And I'd be like, okay, well, movie gone. No, because I did not want to be that person. So I worked my business for a year. And within a year, I had promoted twice. Actually, my second promotion was actually a double promotion. So I was all the way up the company ladder by the time I hit my year mark and went, okay. So the new commitment to myself is I'm not allowed to say no to my business while I'm having a bad day, right? Seems fair.
Yeah.
You know, because we all have bad days. And so That's what started me down the path of network marketing, direct sales. And then I moved into coaching in 2017 because of the level of success I had achieved. And I had people literally asking me, begging me to coach them to get the same results. So stepped out on my own in 2017, became a network marketing and direct sales coach, trainer, and expert, and have been doing it ever since.
I have two things I want to touch base with. So you recently interviewed on your podcast one of my mentors, Jordan Adler, and the quote that I keep in my head whenever I think about Jordan is never quit on a bad day. You know, he always says never quit on a bad day. And that, so I've been with the same direct sales company for nine and a half years, because I don't quit on a bad day. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, there have been some really bad days. There have been some really bad days. There's that. And then the other thing I want to talk about is teachers. Once upon a time, 25 years ago, someone tried to recruit me into Mary Kay, and I laughed at her because... Because I don't know if you can tell or not, but I don't wear makeup. I'm not a frou-frou girl, you know. I throw a wig on and I'm done, right? Mm-hmm. Sometimes I'll put on some eyebrows because, you know, I don't really have a lot of eyebrow. Sometimes I put on some eyebrows, but that's about it, right?
Sure.
Don't do a lot of makeup. And I just thought, why would I be attracted to a company like Mary Kay? And she, you know, she said that I really offended her by laughing at her, but I was like, are you looking at me?
Yeah. Yeah.
She goes, but you have such a great personality. So long story short, or fast forward 15 years, I actually started with Arbonne. And it was a skincare. They have really good skincare. Yes. I'm no longer at Arbonne. It's a great company, but I'm not with Arbonne anymore. But I love the skincare. And every time I would try to build that business, in the back of my head, I was thinking, I laughed at the Mary Kay chick, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's not where I was going with the story. Holy cow, I just got squirreled. That was a squirrel.
Yep.
Okay, so I got squirreled.
It happens. Right.
Anyway, the highest income earners in Arbonne at the time were all former teachers.
Yep.
There is something magical about teachers. They know how to sell because they do it every day.
Exactly. And, you know, the number of teachers who I had turned me down saying, well, I don't know how to sell. And I went, are you freaking kidding me? You sell why kids should do their homework every damn day. Like, you know how to sell. You just don't know how to sell this product yet.
A bunch of kids are looking at long division on the blackboard and they're, oh, geez, that just revealed my age, blackboard. On the whiteboard, not understanding what those numbers mean or what that stupid house looking thing is, you know.
Yeah.
And you sell them on the idea that they can do long division.
Yep. Exactly. Yeah. You walk them through the process. You take them through step by step. And that's really what sales is. And helping people solve a problem.
So why do you think people think sales is a dirty word?
Oh, people think sales is a four-letter word because of how they feel after they interact with someone who is all about themselves and not about the customer. Because every single one of us can, you know, if I were to ask the question, how many amazing, I'm talking like top-notch sales experiences can you think of right now? When I ask that question, most people can think of one, maybe two, right? Most people can kind of think of one, maybe, right? But then when I say, how many bad sales experiences can you think of? Like they immediately go, oh my gosh, like there's not enough fingers on my hands. There's not enough fingers and toes. Like, literally, I've had people tell me hundreds. They've had hundreds of bad sales experiences. And so people think sales is a bad and dirty word. They think it's a bad thing. They think it's a necessary evil, right? They recognize sales need to happen in order for a business to stay afloat, right? They recognize that. And at the same time, they don't know how to do it in a way that isn't all about them. And what they don't, and all they focus on is what they don't want to do in sales rather than focusing on what they do want to do in sales, which is connect with people, solve a problem. That's all sales is. If you can come from that mindset of, I'm just here to solve people's problems. Now, Candace, you've met my good friend and my coach, Virginia Moosekeys. She and I regularly tell people, like both of us, we have 100% sales rate, 100% closing rate. When I talk to somebody, 100% of the time, I'm getting a sale. But here's the thing. I'm not always selling for me. I am putting the person who's on the other side of that Zoom call or the other side of that table at the Panera or wherever I'm sitting having coffee with somebody. I'm finding out what their biggest obstacle is. What's their biggest challenge? What's their biggest struggle in their life right now? Who do you need to meet to fix that problem? I'm going to introduce you to that person. And I have 100% closing rate because sometimes it's me and sometimes it's someone else.
That is brilliant. It's brilliant. It's a giver's attitude. Mm-hmm. What's that book? We were just talking about it before the show.
Infinite Giving.
By
Dr. Ivan Meisner. And I'm blanking on the other two authors. They're two British guys.
It's not Berg. That's wrong. And then there's another one, Go Giver. Those are both.
Yes. Go Giver is Bob Berg.
So Go Giver is Bob Berg and Infinite Giving somebody else. You know what? MomGeek.com/94, the books and their authors will be in the show notes.
Yes, exactly. No, I've actually read Infinite Giving and it took me less than 2 hours to read it total. I think I read it over the course of a couple of days, an hour here, an hour there, and boom, I was done. And it's a book that I'm probably going to go back and read every single year because I just read it a couple of months ago. But it is so mind-opening and mind-blowing in this being able to, you know, put others before yourself. And you don't have to worry about sales because when you do that, you begin to attract other people who put others before themselves, and they start, which means there are people out there who are putting you before them. Mm-hmm. So they are referring to you. They are sending people to you, introducing people to you who need the products or services that you offer in order to make their life better.
I have to tell the audience a funny story. You know half of this story, so I'm going to tell the audience the full story, and then you can hear the other half. So several weeks ago, I got a joint Facebook message from a person in my downline and a man I'd never met. And it basically said, Candace, I want to introduce you to Brian. I'm just going to use his first name, Brian. It's Lori and Brian. So Lori and Brian, if you're listening, this is about you. So Lori introduced me to Brian. She goes, I want to introduce you to Brian. He has a direct sales coaching program I think that you might be interested in learning more about. So Brian and I had a one-on-one, and as I was talking to him, it occurred to me that the person he really needed to talk to was Jennie Bellinger.
Yes.
So that right there is an example of infinite giving.
Yes, you know? Exactly. And two, the other part that comes up in that is most people would go, oh, Brian's a direct sales coach. Jennie's a direct sales coach. They're competition. No, we're not. 100%, we are not competition.
Right? I would guarantee you that Brian is not branded Badass Direct Sales, BDSM.
No. 100%, no. I'm the only one who's got it, right? We are individuals who coach, teach. We may have some similar concepts. We may talk about things. Talk about similar topics. We may have 90% overlap, but here's the thing. It's the uniqueness of each of us that makes it different. And so somebody doesn't have to try and decide, you know, which one's going to work better for me. Because here's the thing. I want what is best for people. And if it's not me, I will introduce them to the person who is best. So bringing Brian onto my summit, bringing Brian onto my podcast is a no-brainer because I'm okay with putting somebody who is quote-unquote competition in front of my audience. Because here's the thing, if they haven't made the decision to work with me yet, they're not ready to work with me yet. And that's okay.
Well, and I really don't believe in competition.
Agreed.
I just don't think that if you're always adversarial, you're not going to get a lot done. You're not going to get a lot accomplished.
Yeah. Your focus is on the wrong thing. If you're focused on the competition adversarial piece, mm-hmm. you're not focused on your ideal client and what their needs are and how you can best fulfill those needs and solve those problems without worrying about all the things. Because here's the thing. There are 7.5 billion people in the world, right? At this point in time, the last statistic I saw, there's about 18.5 million Americans who are in direct sales. Let's say half of them are serious. A quarter of 18 million is what? 4.5%?
Yeah. 4.5 million. Yeah.
Yeah. 4.5 million people. I can't serve 4.5 million people. I can't do it.
Yeah. And you live in St. Louis. How big is that city? With the suburbs and everything?
Oh, the city with all the suburbs, maybe 1 million-ish.
It's a small city.
It's a small city. Yeah, we're not like New York. We're not like Houston. No. I think we're at like 1 million-ish.
So I don't live in Houston anymore, but I used to live in Houston, and there were I remember going to network marketing meetings, and there'd be about 70 people in the room, and people would be disappointed. How come there's not only 7 people here? And I would go, there's 7 million people in the greater Houston area, and there's 70 people in the room. I really like those odds.
Yeah. And here's the thing, given what we're going through, and frankly, I was working online, I was coaching virtually before COVID ever hit. Like, so when COVID hit, I was like, no pivot here. I'm already online. It's all good. Right. I didn't have to worry about that. But honestly, I mean, thinking about that 4.5 million people who are my potential customers, even out of that 4.5 million, they're not my ideal. Out of that, there's maybe 1 million of them who are close to being a good client for me. If we really want to go ideal, maybe 250,000. Guess what? I still can't serve 250,000 people. I can't do it. There's not enough days in the week. There's not enough hours in the day. I can't serve that many people at the level that I want to serve.
So as a coach who teaches unique selling proposition,
yes,
I'm going to tell you that your niche isn't narrow enough if you think you can serve 250,000 people.
Well, and I'm being very broad, right? Super very broad for the purposes of the people who are listening, because the idea of niching down is out there, or niching down. Six one way, half dozen the other, say it both ways. The idea of niching down, especially in the world of network marketing and direct sales, is still something that a lot of people have trouble with, because they're like, but my products can help everybody, right? And when you say that, when you talk about it like that, I can tell you exactly why you're selling to nobody, right?
Mm-hmm.
So for the purposes of helping your audience begin to understand, okay, yes, in the broader sense, yes, I absolutely am. But if I were to tell you really, really and truly my niche, my target market, my ideal prospect, whatever you want to call it, my avatar, I've got a very, very specific one, very specific. You want me to share it with you so people can see how niched down I am?
Absolutely.
My absolute favorite people to work with are women who are moms, who are married, who are preferably in pure romance, doTERRA or Prove It. I love working with those three companies. They are very open-minded and they don't have a problem with me. In fact, they often think it's hilarious, especially the pure romance ladies. They love it. Love it.
Goes hand in hand with the pure romance ladies.
Right? It really does. It works perfectly. And my clients are also in the process of moving, trying to get their business to the point where they are replacing their income from their part-time or full-time job. And here's where it gets really niche down. And their sponsor left the business. They are direct sales orphans and they are floundering. They have just enough success that they're not going to leave too, that they're going, but I'm making $250 a month. I'm making $500 a month. I'm making $1,000, whatever that number is. I'm making just enough, but now they feel disconnected and they don't have their go-to anymore because their sponsor left. So those direct sales orphans, they love working with me because I become the upline they wish they had.
I think that, and I, you know, you've been around in the business a while, so I may be wrong, but I look at the people who've made it really, really big in the companies that are out there that I personally know of or know, and they really don't have uplines. They may have someone who sponsored them who doesn't work the business at all and just takes in a check, you know, because they worked really hard, but their sponsor just gets a check every month. But they do it without the upline.
Yeah.
Regardless of whether or not there's an upline.
Right.
And honestly, I found success in network marketing when I stopped thinking I needed an upline to make it work.
Right. And here's the thing. Each and every one of those people that you just talked about, each and every one of them has a coach or a mentor.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
They may not have an upline, but they found someone to fill that void and be their support, even if they had to invest in that person to get there.
Yes.
Because I can tell you, I know from talking to Jordan, he's had coaches over the years.
Yes.
He didn't do it alone, right?
If you don't know who Jordan Adler is, Google him. I mean, it's beach money. Beach money. He's brilliant.
Beach money, better than beach money. Love that man. Love, love, love that man.
Richard Branson is his mentor. I mean,
I know.
Ivan Meisner is his mentor. He has found people to mentor him that are so far and above. Jordan Adler has a ticket to be on Virgin Galactic. Yep. He already bought his ticket, people. I mean, he bought his ticket. I've known him for 9 years. He bought his ticket 9 years ago or more. You know, they think people who make it to that level in network marketing and direct sales, they think to the future. It's not a date. They have a plan, and a coach like Jennie will get you there. I'm not a direct sales coach. I'm a marketing coach. So they have a plan to get you there, right? They help you make a plan to get you to where you want to be. And it's not going to be fast and furious like you think you want it to be. You have, it's incremental. I mean, I'm just going to admit it. I gained 20 pounds in the last 18 months. I didn't gain a pound a month immediately. It put on a pound a month over the pandemic. Okay. It's not going to take me 5 days to take off that 20 pounds. It took me a year and a half to gain. Right.
Exactly. Exactly. And frankly, it's been my experience just in the decade plus that I've been in the direct sales and network marketing world, that oftentimes those what I call firecracker people, these are the people you see come into your company. Within 6 months, they've hit the middle of the promotion or rank ladder, right? They've leveled up halfway in 6 months, and like you're hearing their name and seeing their name on all of the recognition stuff. They might even speak at convention, and then a year later, gone. They burn out, they fizzle, right? So anybody who wants that long-term success, you've got to go with the slow and steady wins the race, right? That tortoise. So I like to work with the people who are not, I don't want to work with firecrackers because they're going to burn out. They're going to blame me. They're going to do whatever and go elsewhere, which is fine. Go coach with someone else. I don't want a firecracker. I want someone who's going to put things in place, implement, take action, stay the plan, tweak the plan, do the thing, and allow me to help push their boundaries just a little bit. I'm not going to shove you out of your comfort zone. No, I'm not the kid who used to push people into the pool. I'm the person who talked you into the high dive ever so slowly, and then you dove off the high dive for the first time. That was me.
That's the best kind of coach. So let's just talk about compensation plans for a minute. If you join a company and you make it to the middle rank in 6 months, chances are you're not making a lot of money because you're not building the, I mean, network marketing is about network. It's about the network part of it, right?
Wait, Candace, stop right there. People in network marketing have to network?
I know.
No.
I know. I know.
Wow. It's crazy. Yeah. No, the number of people who I talk to, and when I ask them how they're building their base, just like you were just now talking, building their network, how are you building your network? And they look at me and go, what? How are you meeting new people? How are you expanding your network? And they have no idea what I'm talking about. I'm like, you're in network marketing. It's 50% of your job is to network. You're not doing 50% of your job. If you're not networking somehow online, in person, in this day and age, yes, we're still in the middle of COVID crazy stuff, right? Not going to get political about it, but there are places where you can go network in person now in the United States anyway. I don't know if that's true in other countries, but here in the US, we do have some open networking with stuff, you know, masking, social distancing, all of that, but there are places to network. And if you don't want to go in person, there's online network options as well. And so if you're not building your base, if you're not building your network, if you're not growing over time, the number of people that are in your contacts, you're not doing your job and you're not going to find success at all, let alone, I mean, that the people who firecracker are the people who reach back out with each company they jump to, because they keep doing the firecracker thing at 7 different companies. Because I can't tell you the number of people in my Facebook feed. Sorry if y'all feel called out because you're listening to this, but the number of people in my Facebook feed who I've seen be a part of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different companies and do the firecracker thing at every single one of them. What they're doing is going back to the same well, to the same well, to the same well with a new product, new service. Each and every time they burn out their well, they go to the next company and go, hey, Jenny, I got a new thing. And they're going back to the same well again. That's why they burn out.
Yeah, there's only so much protein shake a person can buy from you.
Yeah. And if you think about it too, a firecracker fizzles because it runs out of energy. It runs out of fuel, literally runs out of fuel. And that's why it then just does its thing.
Firecrackers explode and then it's just a bunch of little parts.
Yeah. They explode. They burn out. They literally burn out. Yeah. They burn out. They and then fizzle. They look pretty. And then nothing. You forget and it moves on. Right?
Exactly.
So, yeah. But the compensation plan, back to the network piece. You were going somewhere with that. And sorry, well, I squirreled you.
You actually took it where it needed to go. Okay. So,
okay, good.
We need to wrap up soon, but I want to talk about Badass Direct Sales Mastery Summit and your free gift that you have for the audience. So you can just talk, do whatever you want. It's your show.
Oh, Candace, I love you, girl. So the Badass Direct Sales Mastery Summit, we are having the second one in September of 2021. So if you're listening to this and it is after September 25th of 2021, I'm so sorry you missed the one this fall, but that's okay. I'm doing them twice annually, every March, every September, because I like pain. I'm the direct sales domme. So I am putting on a virtual summit. This summit is going to have 24 speakers who are talking in various industries. So I've got a social media image expert who gets people to stop the scroll by helping people create beautiful images that actually get people to stop scrolling on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram and pay attention to your content. I've got Candace coming on. Oh my God. To talk about, oh my gosh, we just talked about this pre-interview. What was it that you said you're doing?
Unique selling proposition.
That's right. Unique selling proposition.
I'm going to help people find their niche. So if you have no idea who your niche is, come to my 30 minutes. You'll have a niche by the time we're done.
Absolutely. Yes. So Candace is going to be talking about niche. I have the CEO and founder of Contact Mapping coming on to talk about how to create powerful connections to build a powerful business. So if you are not aware of Contact Mapping, if you don't know Adrian and Tom Chenault, they are going to be on the summit talking as well.
That's huge. And they are legends in network marketing.
I know. And they're my friends now. Can you believe it? I'm such a lucky girl.
It's because you're a giver. It's your go-giver.
I am. I really am. And that's why I put the summit on, is because I have this amazing network. I mean, I've got someone coming on. I've actually got two different speaking coaches, one who teaches people how to actually communicate during their public talks. So if you have difficulty with giving your presentations, whether it's on, it doesn't matter if it's on Zoom or in a house party or out in a public setting, he can teach you how to communicate. We've got another speaking coach who's going to teach people how to get paid to speak. Yeah. Yeah. So if you want to learn how to get paid to speak and then still be able to build your business, because then you need to come to the summit. It's a totally free ticket. You just Candace is going to put her link in the show notes for this. So make sure you click on the show notes and go grab the link so you can sign up to attend. It is totally free. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, September 23rd, 24th, and 25th, 3 days, 24 speakers. That means there's 24 hours of content. Oh my gosh, that's a part-time job right there. That's okay. We do have upgrades that will allow you to get access to the recordings after the summit is over. So that way you don't miss out on anything, because I know FOMO is real and I don't want people to miss out on things. So we do have two ticket options where people can upgrade into a paid ticket to get the recordings and extra little goodies as well.
So this is time sensitive. I mean, the 25th is in 2 days, if you're listening to it on the day this episode drops. So what happens if somebody finds this episode in October?
If they find it in October, they can still go to your link and it'll sign them up for the next one.
Awesome sauce.
Right? Because as soon as September 26th rolls around on the calendar, my system will automatically roll everybody over into the March dates, which we haven't established yet at the time of this recording, but will be established by the time the summit starts on September 23rd of 2021. So we have that going on. But then for your listeners, the gift I have for you guys right now, you can go access. I have a little mini course. It is called the No Product Puking Pitch. It's a 20-minute video course and broken up into 5 little videos that are 4 minutes or less each. And it helps you understand how to sell without puking product or even necessarily saying your company name or anything, but be able to help walk someone through your process to get to the point where they are begging you for your product or your service so that you can sell. And there's even a little special gift in one of the videos that teaches you how to go back to the people who already said no without pissing them off. So the No Product Puking Pitch teaches you how to have conversations in a way that turns into actual sales.
And sales is not a dirty word.
It's not.
Not a dirty
word. It's not a dirty word. It's not. Sales makes the world go round. It's wonderful. And once you shift your thinking around sales, it becomes your favorite thing to do. It really does.
How do you feel about people who say that you're not selling, you're sharing?
They're wrong. They're not wrong. They're not wrong, because here's the thing. When you share about maybe a new restaurant that opens in your town, right? You basically shared about it, and that's a sale. It's just the restaurant didn't know it came from you and you didn't get paid. And in fact, you just made your life harder, because now it's harder to get into that restaurant because you opened your mouth 3,000 times and now they have too many people and you have a waiting list, right?
Whereas every single time I have a favorite ethnic restaurant and I tell people about it and then the restaurant starts to get busier, they they de-ethnicize their food, so it gets less and less ethnic.
Oh.
the more popular the restaurant becomes, and so the restaurant goes down. So I stopped telling people about the best restaurants. No,
no, I do believe it is sharing, but here's the key: there in that no product puking pitch mini course, I do have in there some something that I call permission-based selling, or what one might call permission-based sharing. I teach people how to get permission so that people actually are okay with you solving their problem, right? That you talking about how to solve their problem, what you have to offer to solve their problem, whether it's somebody else or your own products or services. There's a way to do that with permission. They actually say, yes, please tell me more. But you have to know how to get to that point. And that's what the rest of the mini course teaches you.
And I think you just said the magic word, solving the problem. Because mm-hmm. that's why people think sales is a bad word, because there are people that, well, that's the puking part of it.
Yeah.
If you're puking all over anybody who's within 3 feet of you about something that has completely no relevance whatsoever to what that person needs, they're not going to want to talk to you. But if you meet somebody and they say something and you do have a solution to them, for them.
Yeah.
That's it. I'm going to actually invest 20 minutes of my time and take your course.
Yes. Thank you.
It's at momgeek.com/94. Hey.
All right.
Okay. Before we wrap up, what should I do for my 100th episode?
Oh, what should you do for your 100th episode? You know, there's a few different things you could do since you always ask for or have book recommendations, whatever it may be. Maybe have a whole episode where it's like nothing but the book recommendations, or I don't know, or a panel discussion with some of your favorites or your top downloaded episode guests. You know, go look at your numbers and take a look at, okay, these are my top 10, and invite them to be part of a panel discussion or your own personal favorites, whatever. Because I won't be your top downloaded by the time you hit 100, but, well, maybe I will. I should not say that, because I am the top downloaded episode for at least 7 other podcast hosts, according to their statistics. So, because I know how to promote.
People like that BDSM theme.
Yeah, it's so much fun.
We're all secret freaks.
Yeah. Let me tell you, honestly, when I first started the podcast, I had a few people go, really? Aren't you afraid of scaring people off? And I said, no, if they're scared of that, then they're not my client. It's totally fine. But the number of people who approached me privately, either through Messenger or later in person, because they wanted to make sure no one else could ever possibly see it or know that their quote unquote dirty little secret. The number of people who came out to me going, I'm in the lifestyle too. It was really amazing, because it allowed people to share a piece of themselves that frankly wasn't all that shocking for me, because some people you go, yep, that makes sense. That makes sense that they're into that. Okay. Totally cool.
It's like when somebody comes out as gay and you've known they were gay since they were 3.
Yeah. 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 Pretty much. You know, it's like you, when somebody goes, yeah, I'm in that too. You go, totally cool. And I think too, that's also a testament to how safe people feel around me. Right. I am a safe place. I am a safe space. I do not hold judgment for anything. Well, you know, murder and the other really bad things, but for the most part, in terms of how you live your life, in terms of how you do things, you do you, boo. Like that's fine. That may not be how I would do something, but I'm not going to judge someone for it. I'm going to let them live their life and do their business the way they want to. But for me, that really showed me that I really truly must be a safe person and safe place for people to go to, because if they could share this really intimate part of their lives, that was an honor for me, honestly, to know that about people. And it also allowed some other conversations to get started too. Like, ooh, tell me more about that. Because I do actually include some kink theme in some of my episodes because that, hello, sex sells and it's fun. You know.
Oh, I love it. Sex sells and it's fun. Okay, be careful. I actually know I hate that I just said a bad word. I have a hard stop in 4 minutes, so we got to wrap up. But okay. I actually have a friend who's she's a graphic designer, and she uses sex all over her graphic design work, and it's tasteful but provocative, and it works so well. I should hook the two of you up.
I would love to have her on the podcast to talk about that, because really there's got to be some great. I'm sure there are some great things in there with that. And yeah, by the way, I do have my writing crop right here. It's fun.
I don't judge.
No, yeah,
and
exactly.
I think that's why I like you. I like you because you're open-minded and you know, you don't judge other people. I don't judge other people. And we just, you know, everybody can get along. All right.
Love each other.
Yes. And you are a giver. All right. So for whom are you grateful, or for what are you grateful?
At this point in time, I'm going to say BNI right now, because without BNI, I wouldn't have met you. Without BNI, I wouldn't have met my best friend and coach, Virginia Mooskies. Without BNI, I would not have met my current love of my life. And I say current just because I have an ex, as y'all heard in the bio. Because of BNI, I met a lot of different people who wouldn't be in my life otherwise, and I would not be where I am without BNI, honestly. BNI taught me it's not just about networking. It's not just about referrals. There is a huge education, lifelong learning piece in there. And because of that, it made me better in my direct sales business and took my business to places and took me to places I never would have been without it. And so I am infinitely grateful, infinite. And I use that term on purpose, because I am infinitely grateful for BNI, infinitely grateful for Dr. Meisner starting this in his kitchen in 1985. Because it has literally, if for nothing else, changed my life so immensely and enriched my life that I can't imagine not being a part of BNI. Had BNI closed down in the middle of COVID, that would have made me lose my mind. More than anything else, that would have made me lose my mind, because I identify as a BNI member. I am a lifer because I love it. I love everything it stands for when you really get to the core of it all. So grateful to the nth degree to BNI.
Thanks for joining us this week on Be Who You Want to Be, Your Business, Your Life, episode 94. Check the show notes at momgeek.com/94 for links to the resources mentioned today. Be sure to follow us on iTunes, Stitcher, Audible, and Amazon Music, or wherever you listen to podcasts so you never miss an episode. Hey, listen up. You and I both know that you are dazzling and you're spectacular and you possess magical gifts like no one else in the whole world. Micro Influencer Magic was created just for you. Book your discovery call with me to learn how micro influencer magic can help you cast your spell. Look for the link in the show notes, momgeek.com/94. Our theme music is Never Give Up, written and performed by Soul Lily. I've been your host, Candice Ridardi. Yes, you can be who you want to be. Take it away, Soul Lily.
Feel your spirit, let it soar. Fly away and be free. Take less, always give a little more now. Be what you want to be. Oh, never give up on dreams. Never give up on dreams. Never give up, never give up. Never give up on dreams.